Assessment of Tensile and Fatigue Behavior of Pig Specimens in a Physiologically Relevant Environment by Mirko Peron, Jan Torgersen and Filippo Berto from Norwegian University of Science and Technology. Due to the continuous increment in the demand of implant devices, researchers have focused their attention on the development of new biocompatible materials, in particular polymers. Among them, polyether ether ketone has gained wide interest in load-bearing applications such as spinal cages due to its high specific mechanical properties, high glass transition temperature, and high corrosion resistance. As stated by Kurz and Wien, implant fracture could be considered important potential failure modes for PEEK biomaterials in the spine, a design tool for assessing the tensile fatigue behavior of PEEK, especially in the presence of notches, is thus highly claimed. To this aim, tensile and fatigue data available in literature have been considered. Unnotched and differently notched PEEK samples, circumferentially cracked and U-notched specimens with different notch ready, have been tested by other authors in a phosphate buffer saline solution at 37 Celsius degrees, and they have been here analyzed in terms of the strain energy density approach. The criterion formulated by Lazzari and Zambardi in 2001 states that failure occur when the strain energy or the strain energy range for fatigue loading average over a circular control volume of radius RC surrounding a crack or a notch tip reaches its critical value WC or its critical range delta WC if fatigue is considered. The method is shown to provide accurate results regardless of the different notch geometries both for tensile and fatigue data. Concerning the former, the tensile strength was in fact estimated with an error lower than plus minus 10%, regardless of the strain rate. Dealing with fatigue loading, the SED approach was able to summarize the fatigue data within a single narrow scatter band independently from the notch geometry.